Today for our daily cancellation, we are going to briefly discuss the dire controversy surrounding Ben Shapiro's article in Politico. If you don't spend a lot of time on social media, then your life is a whole lot more fulfilling and meaningful than those of us who do. But the downside is you miss important news like this. It was trending all over Twitter yesterday. People were very upset that Ben Shapiro wrote an article for Politico's newsletter called The Playbook. And Ben's piece was mostly about impeachment and trying to explain, you know, why many Republicans oppose it from his point of view. And his argument comes down to this paragraph where he says, quote, opposition to impeachment comes from a deep and abiding conservative belief that members of the opposing political tribe want their destruction, not simply to punish Trump for his behavior. Republicans believe that Democrats and the overwhelmingly liberal media see impeachment as an attempt to cudgel them collectively by lumping them in with Capitol rioters thanks to their support of Trump. Okay, now you might think, well, okay, that seems reasonable. Certainly not in any way offensive or traumatizing or radical. But many in media and many employees at Politico didn't agree. They claimed that Politico had acted in a deeply irresponsible fashion by allowing Ben Shapiro to write a newsletter. They pointed out that Ben Shapiro, an Orthodox Jew, is also a white supremacist Nazi. A white supremacist Nazi Orthodox Jew. I mean, those exist, I'm told. There's at least one of them. They pointed out that he has opinions, many opinions, some of which they, the members of the media, don't agree with. And it's simply not acceptable for a person with those sorts of opinions to be allowed in Politico or, frankly, anywhere else on earth. Eric Wemple, media critic for The Washington Post, was tweeting updates on the controversy throughout the day. There was apparently a revolt among Politico staffers who felt that they all personally should have been consulted before their boss made the decision to let Ben Shapiro write a guest column for them. Wemple tweeted, there are now upwards of 225 people on the Politico Zoom call convened to hash out the decision to invite Ben Shapiro to guest write an edition of Playbook. People are very mad, I am hearing. Very, very mad. This is the kind of thing you hear about a lot these days. Underlings at companies getting their feelings hurt by decisions that don't personally affect them in any way whatsoever. Then they cry about it publicly and management for some reason takes their temper tantrum seriously and gives them a forum to vent their childish rage. In fairness, you might point out that my company has given me a forum to vent my childish rage also, and it's the very show you're listening to right now, but that's beside the point. This isn't about me. This is about Ben Shapiro. And he is the one canceled today. Now, please don't think that I would cancel all the people who've broken down in tears over a completely inoffensive and utterly reasonable article in Politico written by a conservative. No, I understand their feelings. I also wept uncontrollably when I first read it. I could not stand to see the sacred, hallowed ground of the Politico playbook so desecrated. The Politico playbook is deeply important to many people, you see, myself included. I have been a huge lifelong fan of the Politico playbook ever since I first heard about it yesterday afternoon. And at any rate, Ben should know that when you're a conservative, you have no right to make your arguments or express your beliefs in any mainstream forum. You shouldn't even be seen in public without prior warning. I've always said this, that conservatives ought to wear cowbells around their necks when they leave their homes so that strangers will be warned of their imminent arrival into a room. See, it's bad enough to simply be seen, you know, to force others to endure the spectacle of your existence. As a conservative, merely by your presence in a room, you run the risk of causing fatal emotional wounds to everybody in the vicinity. But to actually speak, to express your beliefs and ideas, to make arguments, well, that's tantamount to terrorism, mass murder. This is an absolutely true story. Okay, I promise you. I was at a Thanksgiving dinner once, a few years ago. One of the people at the table was a conservative. And he was explaining, you know, why he believes in gun rights. He was making his arguments. And I'm not exaggerating when I tell you that four people in the dining room dropped dead on the spot. I mean, they disagreed so strongly with the arguments that their hearts gave out and they perished. It was a bloodbath. So this is what's at stake. Ben, by writing an article for Politico, has shown a reckless disregard for the feelings and therefore the lives of so many Americans. And that's why I move not only to cancel Ben Shapiro, but also to impeach him. I will be drawing up articles of impeachment this afternoon. He is charged with incitement, treason, and other acts of general and unspecified meanness. May God have mercy on his soul. And may God comfort the staff at Politico in this trying time. Well, I hope you enjoyed that clip from the Matt Walsh Show. If you did, go ahead and hit that subscribe button right down there so you can stay up to date on all of our future content.